predators.
Connection complete.
We're doing the thing that we do here.
We're doing some real things.
The noisy thing.
There's some terrible things out there.
Yeah, so we're about to take you to church. But don't worry, it's safe in this church, apparently.
Yeah.
In this one.
That's sad, we have to say that.
Yeah. Pray for Charleston. I know I will.
Daytime might be night.
Squeezed in slip between those bumpers like rolling flint. But the entrance to the lot has a human lock. I don't think he likes my looks. Charged the halo's light and thought I had it made, but they'd like to hang me up on a hook. The time to run is now. Grabbed the curtain's cord and pulled it down. Dignified into an awful rout. Stranded in a place that can't be redeemed. Forced to ride the pine with the second team. And the entrance to the lot has a human lock. I don't think he likes my looks. Judging by my day, you'd think I haven't made. But they'd like to hang me up on a hook. The time to run is right now.
Charleston can't tell you where it is.
Nope. It doesn't know where Charleston Street is.
It doesn't It doesn't have any real, you know, like, this is the way to the museum or anything. You know, right. Even the children's museum is more recognizable than the slave.
I used to hate it when I used to work on Market Street, and everyone used to think that
that's the slave market,
which it was. The slaves sold goods there, but they thought that was the same market where slaves are bought and sold. It's a different location.
Yep, sold on the courthouse steps.
Need to know. I mean, that was real stuff, and it was recent history and in all reality. They're still flying the Confederate flag on our state house. So.
And our mayor, Joe Riley, openly marched against them and said that, and you know, I'm not for let's just burn history and forget about history. The damn thing should be encased in a box like the Nazi flags are in the Holocaust camp.
Right. I'm burning down the Confederate cemeteries or anything, because, or erasing the history of the past. The past is still here. We still got monuments, all those generals. Calhoun is still in Marion Square.
It represents something bad.
Yeah. It should be taken down.
Like, they don't still fly the Nazi. They don't still fly the Nazi flag over Germany for history reasons. Like,
for historical reasons. They don't even
take it down. It's not our state flag.
They don't even fly the communist Russian flag under the new Russian flag. You know,
it's not the rebel flag. It's the Confederate flag. It was a flag of a separate government that no longer exists.
We're here for
they
you.
They lost.
We're the only country.
No, we're still here for you.
What is it? You cut off that tail, it's still wiggling.
You're still here for you.
We're the only country in the world that is so dedicated to preservation that we will overlook racism and hatred just to preserve something that you think
matters when in reality is nothing but destruction. And it continues the cycle of destruction, and nothing's going to stop it.
But my granddaddy was a Confederate War general.
Well, I mean, my ancestors definitely fought. I had three great ancestors that fought in the Civil War and were slave owners. I'm not denying that. I will own up to that one bit because I'm not them.
Yeah.
Right. But to just whitewash over this history like we're just
it didn't happen.
You know, it's insulting to the modern society that we come to today,
and it's insulting to history, really.
Like Malcolm X said, you know, I have more respect for South Africa, where you openly have your apartheid and are open about your racism, than America, where you preach that you are free but practice segregation and discrimination.
It's a lot of things happening in the world. A lot of things happening right here in Charleston.
A lot of noise.
Yeah, it's a hotbed.
It's a hotbed.
Absolutely.
A lot of
noise.
And I mean,
this is the noise of the show.
And a lot of the conflicting reports and stuff, I mean, people, just use your damn common sense. Don't make this an agenda issue. The NRA didn't have anything to do with this. The anti-gun people didn't have anything to do with this. This is what happens when violent people choose violent action.
That being said, though, a little bit less access to guns never...
Oh, definitely. I'm 100% with you. But the fact that this is the only thing people are turning it into before the tragedy's even settled, you know, this is far more about racial problems in America than about access to guns.
Yeah.
You know, that is a major issue in America.
It's definitely a conversation we need to have, especially a conversation here in Charleston,
but,
where
you know,
South is still deemed to rise again.
Know,
there's still plenty of people.
Gun control is a conversation.
We're here for you. We're here for you.
Gun control, you've had this conversation since 1970. We've had this race relations conversation and oppression and systemic destruction since the 1600s.
It's a long time, people.
Yeah,
some of your states were not even in existence in the 1600s.
No, but people were still being oppressed. And it,
oh, like, absolutely.
And what they say, as long as one of us is a slave, none of us are free.
Exactly.
And I take that to heart.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
If you allow people to be oppressed, then you are, even if you're not the one doing the oppressor, you're taking part in it, and you're participating in the system that benefits from it. I'll say, as a white man, I have benefited from racism, even when I wasn't being racist.
Oh, it's the
I have benefited from the system that is racist.
It's the complexion.
I've been looked
for
at
the
differently
protection.
By cops. I was given better opportunity. All kinds of things. Just because I was born the way I am, and that's not fair to me or anyone else, really. I don't think.
No, so, not at all.
And I think until we are honest about the dichotomy of realities for different people. Especially in places where they shouldn't exist, in areas like education,
right,
and finance, and there's all kinds of things. That if you systematically leave a whole group of people behind, you can't wonder like why their society is so different. You can't look at black neighborhoods and be like, why are those neighborhoods so different? Why is there such high crime when you like created those neighborhoods?
Exactly.
And then you told the police to go there and look for crime.
Exactly.
You can't be like, why?
There's no opportunity.
It's not like they're policing the white neighborhoods in the same way. Or
there's no...
We don't have planes and boats and trains to bring in guns. We can't do that.
There's no...
The only person that had a boat was Garvey. And it was jacked up boat.
There's no
so
forward...
CIA, FBI,
and upward
things.
Movement.
Yeah.
And so therefore things stay stagnant.
Organization. Vertical.
And what do you expect people to do when things just stay the same?
They just float, man. That's all they do is float.
What do you expect people to do? It's interesting. That's why I was telling folks, you know, with the incidents that took place in Baltimore, you can't forget the simple fact that you're dealing with folks that don't have education opportunities, aren't making any money, are barely living off of what?
And they've been abandoned.
Like
the cities they live in are left, you know, are left in disrepair. Like.
Exactly. They're very frustrated. What are they going to do? You know, and you were talking about kids, teenagers.
That was the youth in revolt.
And what do little kids, and really still adults, do when they get upset?
they get mad, they have a temper tantrum. That's what we saw was a temper tantrum. I mean, unfortunately, people
They have no other outlet for that energy.
Right. And when you don't have
If you had,
what else are you going to do?
Educated people with jobs are not likely to revolt. Are not likely to cause trouble. Like, they're busy at work. They're, like, and if you, we would just taken the time to do that to begin with, and rather than denying these people these opportunities and that education,
absolutely,
we wouldn't have the problems we have now.
Right, and no way am I actually condoning this and saying, hey, this is what they should have done, but you have to really put your thinking cap on and say, what drove that person to this point where they're just going to go and set something on fire because they're that upset with their condition and the fact that they can't get ahead, move forward, and be productive.
I think everyone really wants that. I think people people tend to forget that. They want to, you know, look at another race and say, oh, they're lazy, they're criminals, they don't want to work. But I think if you really look, if you talk to people and get to know people, like, most people have the same desires in life. Most of us want to have a purpose. Most of us want to, like, fulfill, like, be fulfilled and have, like, most people, like, you say people don't want to work. People don't want to work at a job they hate. Most people like working at jobs. If you can feel fulfilled in your job and make enough money, like you said, take care of your family if you got kids or a wife or a mom or a grandmother that needs help. People want to do that. People want to take care of their family and their loved ones, and they want to do something productive and worthwhile.
And be able to contribute.
Yeah, if you give them that opportunity. Everyone wants to be. This is a society that involves all of us. No one wants to drop out of society. No one wants to be worthless and, you know, like, to be looked at that way.
Absolutely.
You know, I think people forget that. Even people, like,
they don't want to be ignored.
And you look at people that are suffering, that are on welfare and stuff, and people look down on them. And I think that's you shouldn't be looking down on
people
that are suffering.
And welfare is so, you know, misunderstood. People don't understand the different levels of the welfare system, what truly goes on, and the term the welfare queen misnomer that so many people keep bringing up.
My mom got WIC.
Where you have one or two situations where the person skips and screws the system. Well, you know who else does that? Bernie Madoff.
Yeah,
you know who else does
too.
That? Enron. Like, this happens in...
It happens on a much larger scale.
A
on the
much
other end of the
grandiose
scale.
You're acting like the food stamps that are being taken.
Mad at the guy that got some free groceries.
You're mad at some food stamps when millions are being embezzled on Wall Street. And in capital firms and banks on a regular basis,
and there
we
are people
have international
out there that
scandals,
need welfare.
And these are destroying people's pensions. This is way more than the taxpayer losing $100.
Yes. And we are still here for you.
On the Noise of Show.
The
we
Noise
are still
of Show.
Here for you.
Sitting in the Out to Clementa Pinckney, Cynthia Hurd, Sharonda Coleman, Tawanza Sanders, Ethel Lance, Susie Jackson, DePayne Middleton, Dr. Mira Thompson, and Daniel Simmons Sr. Pray for Charleston.
And the Lord knows best.
real people. These are real people with lives and families.
People right here in Charleston. Right here in Charleston.
Your neighbors. Your friends.
People that work helping other people. Taught people how to read.
Right.
They killed every pastor in the church.
Every minister in that church. Every minister in the church.
They wiped the whole...
People in Charleston, like, my mom was worried about ISIS. Like, no. ISIS, you think ISIS is going to kill Christians?
ISIS is not.
I know a guy that killed a bunch of Christians had nothing to do with ISIS, so...
ISIS is not what you
need to be
worried
about. That's not what you need to be scared about. We got plenty of people right here in America that have nothing to do with Islam. Be plenty afraid of. Lock your doors.
Please.
See the light.
That's where education began.
Them tools.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. In the
church. In your toolbox.
Absolutely.
18.
Animation, design, photography.
In 1834.
Music. I learned to play music in church. I learned to sing in church.
Yes.
In 1834.
I learned to talk to other people, greet people with a handshake and my eye contact in church. Like, you learn all kinds of basic skills in church.
But in 1834, the fact that the church was so revolutionarily educated for the slaves at the time, that the slaves that attended this church, this AME church that was formed after the Barbadian slave owners incorporated Christianity with African culture and it assimilated into the AME church. It was originally founded by a pastor from Philadelphia, I believe. But, you know, after the Vesey slave rebellion, and Vesey, you know, is an excellent skilled crafter, blacksmith. I believe he was into architectural design a little bit, but he was into a lot of stuff. You know, very well-versed man, was going to lead a rebellion, and it was quelled, church burned. You know, subsequently, in 1834, a national law was passed banning black congregations and black slave meeting and having church service because of the amount of slaves learning how to read, how to write, how to do, you know, more than the menial task,
trades, which are your tools.
Knowledge is power.
And they were afraid
power is
of
scary. It. Power is scary.
And ignorance is fear. It purely
ignorance is fear, people. It's a lot to be learned. It's a lot of history right here in Charleston that many cities do not have, but it all stems out of what was happening in here centuries ago.
There's only one history.
Yes, yes, yes. And you cannot undo what has been done. Cannot undo it.
You can only move forward from there. Mm-hmm. Which luckily we've made some great strides in the areas of freedom and of religion. I think we made leaps and bounds. I mean, the Catholic Church is changing and growing and becoming more accepting and speaking out against pollution. So I think people are changing. Their ideas are changing. And we've grown a whole lot. We still have a long way to go.
The understanding between cultures a lot has gotten better, but in some cases the hardline extremists, the few bad apples, as DJ Mars likes to say a lot,
it's weird, like,
they just destroy and sour and rot others into their nonsense and their ignorance, and creates a hardline stance that's, you know, archaic.
Yeah, absolutely.
Everything we've become and open. You have your people, you have your friends. Like, I have my friends that are Mormon, and they had, like, pipe organ blowing up. And, you know, I don't believe in that religion, but that's cool. You know, really cool what they
was it because
in.
Of the pipe organ?
I don't know.
Was the pipe organ that ruined it for you? Is all I'm asking. Pipe organ, no, that really does not for me.
The main thing about it is the fact
no
that
pipe organ.
Can't when the pipe. You don't understand it until it comes to you.
Yeah.
See, like, when I was younger, I saw that, and I was like, oh, man, okay, that's bad, but...
But then you had a friend, understand. Or even if you just have a, you like, having a friend of that religion.
Yeah.
Because I had a Mormon friend growing up, too. It was like,
I was sympathetic.
That religion is different. It's strange. It's not like my religion, and it may not be for me.
Exactly.
But the fact that I had a Mormon friend made me realize that not all Mormons are crazy, wacko nut jobs that I, you know. And I think that's a lot of it. Like, I feel like in America, America's a melting pot. You know, we got all religions here. The people that... I mean, there's still a lot of violence in America, I think, attitudes towards, like, Muslims and stuff as well, which as a religion, like...
Oh, that's pure xenophobia.
Yeah.
That's the...
But if you get... If you just... I'm seriously, meet some Muslims, talk to some Muslims, they're fucking cool
people.
They're great people. They're righteous. They want to hang out with you, too.
And they just want to live.
Yeah.
That's all they want to do.
Just like you.
Just like you. Absolutely. It's crazy. I went to school across the street from Emmanuel AME. So not only was I a member of Emmanuel AME, but I was also a member of the school that is directly across the street from that, and it's called Buist Academy.
Mm-hmm.
While I was there
school.
From kindergarten to fifth grade, in fourth grade, one of my friends' family converted to Islam, and our teacher was fascinated by that, and he said, can you show us how you pray one day in class? And he said, sure, absolutely. And for our teacher, our principal, and all of the staff there to understand that, and for the students to be able to be exposed to that, had a profound effect.
That's
on
a real educational experience.
Exactly. Not only that, but we were also able to have a survivor of the Holocaust come and speak to us, because one of our classmates' grandfathers was a survivor of the Holocaust. Showed us the number on his wrist. You know, seeing that at an early age.
First-hand history.
It shapes your mind in a different way that is so profound that you will grow up as a much sharper and more caring person, an understanding person. And you understand that, hey, even though this person doesn't look like me, they've gone through the same kinds of things, or they've gone through different things than me.
And they have felt hunger. They have felt tired.
To achieve a better way of life. It's so powerful.
There's no emotion you have felt that they have also not felt. We've all been sad. We've all been happy. We've all been overjoyed. We've all felt love.
Right.
And speaking,
we're all
of,
the same on that level.
You know, some of the great peacemakers in the world that have come through this church before, you know, in the early 1900s, you had Booker T. Washington come through and speak in the church.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
During the civil rights era in the 60s, you had Martin Luther King Jr. come and speak at the church.
Absolutely.
And, you know, it's really a true, true pinnacle of unity in the Charleston community, the church, the Emanuel AME, and it's just really heartbreaking to see that someone really wishes to try to split a community, tries to just use his hateful rhetoric to scare a community, like telling someone you have to spread the word. You know, this isn't the damn Game of Thrones or something where it's like, you know, this is reality.
Right.
These are human. This is human empathy.
And you're impacting lives.
Like, you know,
many lives. Yeah. Many lives.
But it's, and you know, this was a true act of terrorism. And for people to say, well, you know, the Columbine incident wasn't an act, that's, you know, the same thing as that. Well, no. In Columbine, you can compare that to the movie Basketball Diaries. The kids got a synonymous idea from the Leonardo DiCaprio scene of the shooting up of the classroom. You know, the like we said, the Aurora, Colorado shootings, the Call of Duty scene.
There may have been some kind of impetus or inspiration for those kind of crimes. Where
there
no is
no
inspiration or impetus for this kind of crime.
Supremacy is, or hate.
I think that's why
rhetoric.
This was like so heinous and so unimaginable for a lot of people. Also, like I said, I think the church represents a sanctuary for all of us, and it's supposed to be the one place you can go and be safe from violence, from harm.
It really is.
Like, it's supposed to be the place you're supposed to go when you need
help. This is on par with the Mumbai hotel massacre, where the extreme Islamists went into the hotel, killing only Hindus, and personally pointing out Muslims and saying, okay, you're Muslim, you can go, to create a divisive effect in the community, which it did. There was major breakdown in that community, but not here, because we have better understanding. And this sicko,
absolutely,
this sicko is not going to get his message and his wish granted, because this is what he wants.
He didn't get out the cackalacks, man. North Carolina
was like, no.
Nah, nah, we got
no.
We're not harboring you.
I think we all knew that guy was going to get caught, though. You know?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. It was just a matter of
time. I
think
he knew he was going to get caught.
He's lucky he got caught by the cops and not the Geechee boys searching for him in Charleston. He would
boys.
Be in a swamp right now somewhere, but head off.
That might be a better place for him.
Well, they would have turned him in, but he would have turned him in. He would at least not been crispy clean.
No.
I think it would have been a little bit dirty.
Some scars.
You know.
Some stripes and stars.
Someone hurt him.
Stars and bars.
Just know, justice will be served soon enough. He's back in the state, so we'll get this through. But, you know, we just have to come together as the Charleston community and unite and just stand behind one another.
The fool me once with the Walter Scott, and then you fool me twice. I let you sit down for an hour, and then that happens. It's like, okay, the third time, like...
No, people are losing
patience. You start
to
think about the third time.
People like, are losing patience. You only have so many chances.
Yeah, right, you only... Wait. Life ain't a game show, big bucks, no whammies.
Watch the whammies.
Right?
Big bucks,
people
no
wide.
Whammies.
It's getting tough.
I don't want it to be bad.
No whammies, no whammies, no whammies.
For those of you who don't get the reference, it was a TV show. It was called Press Your Luck.
Press Your Luck!
And there were whammies.
But, you know,
I didn't want to get the whammy.
But it's just sad because...
I still don't want the whammy.
I don't want the whammy.
I prefer the big bucks, for sure.
People
Let's
are
go
now,
big bucks.
People are having to, you know, now be suspicious of people they normally wouldn't be just due to circumstances involved. I mean, you know, this is
I mean, what's the crazy thing is, like, it's taken... Here's my thing. It's taking all of this to make black people suspicious of white people.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, we've, like, oppressed you. Segregated you. Like, all this stuff.
It's a different level of awareness.
Killed you for years.
You can't throw that broad of a spectrum because there are the talented 10 that are enlightened that know, but there are people in, you know, the Northwest that don't know. Or there are people in the Southwest in California that don't know.
Yeah.
Speaking
how it is
down
God
south.
Body knowledge.
There are people up Northeast that haven't gone down south. They don't go past D.C.
They just hear what
Chicago
it's like.
Family that don't go down past D.C. They come to Chicago.
I wouldn't blame them.
They just, to be honest. But they just hear what they know. They don't know what
they're
life
reacting. They're reacting to what they see on the television.
Yeah. But I mean, that's scary. I mean, it's scary. It's scary to see that stuff. I mean,
but I'm thinking it's like to have taken it this much to get this kind of reaction when white people, I think, have this reaction every day, all the time about black people.
Oh,
you see a black guy walking down the street. They get scared. Yeah, walk. They get crawled.
There was a mugging last night.
Like they're all.
It was a homeless black man.
Have the audacity to call them all criminals or all thugs or, you know.
He looks at me.
When there's been no crimes and no atrocities committed
towards
you. They're
jumping the
you.
Fence at the pool. Yeah. We cannot stand for this. Slam her 15-year-old body on the ground.
Yeah.
She has a gun in that G-string.
There's somewhere. It's there. And remember, we're still here for you. We are still here.
Where else
for
will we
you.
Go?
I have last word before we go to break.
All right, we gotta take a break. It's time. We need a break.
We need
a breather.
Cool.
Tez
really
will get this one.
We're gonna go.
Malcolm will get.
Really we're gonna go
one.
Hug it out
more
outside.
Jokes.
Yeah, we gotta.
From
we gotta
McKinney,
do this.
Texas.
We're gonna go cynical. It's gonna be.
Never forget the barrel roll cop.
The barrel roll, babes.
Barrel roll.
The barrel
like,
roll.
Like Star Fox.
Barrel roll.
Came through ready.
Parkour cop!
The scene was so crazy.
He had to do a barrel roll.
I'm doing a barrel roll
to get these teenagers!
He had to avoid shrapnel.
Barrel roll, old.
I think he just tripped on a root and was just playing it off. He was like, just make it look
cool.
It just rolled into it. I meant to do that.
I've been practicing all my life!
But I just.
That's why he's in such good shape.
Yeah.
I don't want this bowl cut to come in style. That's gonna
hopefully
be
this,
SNL.
Hopefully,
cut.
If nothing
that's
else, this kills the bowl cut.
Yeah.
If nothing else, that's no one else will ever get a bowl cut again.
Don't do it.
If we're lucky. Yeah.
You
don't
heard it here on the noise, the show, folks.
No more
bowl
cut.
It's dead.
It's end.
Early Dungeon. 90s, no more.
You can wear JNCOs if you want, but you better not get a fucking bowl cut.
No bowl cuts.
Airwalk's fine. No bowl cut.
If we see a bowl cut.
Wallet chain, fine. Bowl cut, no.
Airwalks and Skechers only.
That's real nice.
I'll second
shoe
that.
Regulations. Break time. Have fun. Listen to the Noises Show. Make some noise of your own.
Please.
Listen every week on Thursday nights.
Tip your bartender.
And take off your shirt.
Please.
And pray.
Pray for Charleston.
democracy. When some man comes along and claims a godly need, he'll clean you out right through your tweed.
That's right, you asked for it. Remember, there's a big difference between kneeling down and bending over.
He's got $20 million in his heavenly bank account.
buildings shake. Voices escape, singing sad, sad songs. Tuned to chords are strung down your cheeks. Bitter melodies turning your orbit around. Voices whine. Skyscrapers are scraping together. Your voice is smoking and last cigarettes.
Stop. Roots.
To defy the laws of tradition. So crusade only of the brave. To defy the laws of tradition.
right. Adam and Eve, Adam and Steve, which is wrong and which is right. Which is wrong and which is right. Which is wrong and which is right. Thank you.
upcoming this Tuesday, the Poor House is having a live benefit for the Manual AME Church after this terrible tragedy we witnessed last night, called Don't Tell Me This Town Ain't Got No Heart. And it will be featuring 25 of Charleston's top musicians. Some very good musicians, a few just to name: Josh Roberts and the Hinges, Dead 27s, Traveling Kind, Danger Muffin, or well, members of Danger Muffin, Runaway Gin, Honey Smoke, and many others. And it's going to be free and open to the public. The suggested donation is $10 per person. The Poor House will donate 20% of bar sales and all tips to the Mayor Joseph Riley's established Mother Emanuel Hope Fund following the event. And it starts at 6, so that's Tuesday, June 23rd. And right now I'm looking at the Facebook page that says it's already got 609 people going.
Oh,
so
man.
It's going to be...
better show up early.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of people.
Poor House isn't that big.
No, it's not.
But
it gets,
you know,
crowded quickly.
Yeah.
If the Charleston beard and mustache... if the Charleston beer and mustache competition could get over $2,000 in funds for the American Cancer Breast Society, we can get up that number for this, you know, this terrible tragedy for the family. Because there's kids that don't have parents anymore. There's kids that don't have grandparents. You know, there's
Reverend Pinckney had two daughters.
Two daughters that were in the building when he was being shot. You know. So
they were hiding under the table with their mother.
So, you know, it's a very worthy cause. I would highly recommend everyone to donate whatever you can. You know, we're not asking for a huge amount. You know, if you feel compelled to donate however much you want, do it. But, you know, everything helps. You know, I think people just need to reach out and try and do whatever they can. You know, if you see someone that's in distress or that's really, really affected by the situation, you know, you need to be
give them a hug,
be there for them the best way you can, you know.
That was the best part. Also, even though, you know, you have extremists not saying the nice, but everybody saying really nice things and just positivity and support, that was the main thing.
The positive energy is real.
That was the best.
And you know,
need to heal,
right?
And you know,
it's real.
I've had friends talk about, you know, going and planting flowers and having, you know, one or two of the people in the crowd calling them crackers and stuff. But, you know, you can't judge someone, especially in the moment of such a tragedy. You know, that's not the group mentality. That's, you know, just a few outside people. There's true unity in this community. And, you know, when people get hurt, they do harsh things. But, you know, words aren't bullets. And what this man did was put bullets in 9 people that will never be returned back to this, you know, planet. This is, you know, and they left behind, you know, legacies of helping others. They left behind families, loved ones, you know. There's literally hundreds of people in the community directly connected on these people on a regular basis. And they're gone.
Altered a lot of lives, altered a lot of lives, impacted a lot of people. This is big time.
Yeah. So help out any way you can. And
go have some fun and get some cool music.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
25 live bands, that's not going to be, you know, a bad joint. I'm sure they're going late into the night.
Yeah. On an unrelated note, you can also come to Tin Roof.
Please
Friday.
Come to the Tin Roof.
It's a totally unrelated event. We're not donating any money to anybody, but we do encourage you to come, enjoy the music, and, you know, hug somebody, make a friend. Friday at the Tin Roof, we got Trollgar, who hasn't played in some large number of days.
A few
the
members,
return of Trollgar.
A few members go to Cuddy's pretty regularly.
Yeah, and then after that is John Wilkes Telephone Booth.
With yours truly, Mr. Brian
DeMage. I'm going to be playing some bass and singing some songs. And then Donnie Knoxville from Athens, Georgia is going to be performing last. He's got some dope raps.
I've heard good things. I've heard
got
good
some
things.
Rhymes. Like I said, we're not affiliated with any charitable organization.
But we do encourage everyone in Charleston to get along.
Is this John Wilkes telephone booth / show?
I think we have two more possibly coming. We're going to do one really big show before I leave town.
Just making sure.
With a bunch of old members. We're going to have like three drummers do that show, I think. And it's going to be a ridiculous show.
That's going to sound really cool.
It's going to be loud. It'll be noise.
It's
going to
be loud, no matter what.
It'll definitely be the noise.
Yeah.
So if you can hear anything besides drum at that show, you're lucky.
You're a lucky person.
We'll see how it goes.
John Wilkes going out with a bang.
Yeah. We like to make noise. And we like to make noise here at the Noises Show every Thursday night from 10 to midnight. Good friend DJ Pat Nasty.
Always
Malcolm and Montez joining us tonight. Thank you guys very much for being here.
DJ Mars and Wiz.
You know it, bro.
Helping us hold it together and helping Pat hold it together. Appreciate everything you guys do. And I want to tell you now, I love you guys. All four of you, or including
you too,
myself.
We love you too.
Always the same.
You know, yeah, man. A lot of love in this room. Love and, you know, I think if everyone in Charleston can get along as well as the four of us, I think we'd be doing all right. So
absolutely, people.
I want to encourage all of you to maybe hang out in a room together with each other and talk. I think if everyone would just hang out in a room together and talk, unarmed.
It's the conversation.
We could be just fine.
It's the conversations we need to have. Yeah. People just get too upset when people talk, and it's not what they want to hear now. You know, like,
gratification.
People need to understand, you know, you can learn from everyone, you know, you don't have to just, like, and when I say that, I'm not meaning some stupid hipster stuff like I'm learning from children and that nonsense BS, like, fuck
that. You can learn a lot from
children. I'm learning from my peers around me and the people that actually have knowledge to give versus those that rather spew ignorance and skew the facts into some nonsense political spin, aka Bill O'Reilly.
I say, surround yourself with positive people.
Bye, Bill.
Bye, Bill.
Bye, Bill. Yeah, surround yourself with positive people.
Absolutely.
And keep your vibes positive, because
you'd be surprised what positive energy can bring people.
Yeah, and
I don't know why you would want any other kind of energy.
Well, minus
what are you doing? Good.
It makes you feel so good. Why would you want bad energy?
It's a waste of time. So much because it's just like so positive. You can't
resist
even when you're hurting so hard.
Someone should ask Steve Ducey that while he munches down on another piece of Pizza Hut's hot dog crust pizza.
Give me some more of that.
Hey, just positivity. If they were to say something nice, it'd make him feel better. That's all. That's simple.
Yeah.
You say something mean, you feel worse.
Yeah.
It's math. That's basic math, guys.
You could go straight to hell, boys.
So if you're centralized and fueled on that hurt, then
go straight to hell.
I mean, look at LeBron's finals.
Damn. Those were rough. He scored a lot of points.
He scored a lot of points, but
didn't win
a lot of games. Why has Kobe got to wear LeBron's finals record on the back of his jersey 42?
That's right.
Actually 24, sorry about that dyslexia. Because LeBron's 2-4, not 4-2. Come back to Miami, LeBron! We'll take you!
Florida. Oh, that's hell.
Come back!
Florida.
We have all the sauce in the world for you, LeBron!
Oh, yeah. It's no Charleston.
Hey, there's no luxury tax for the richest man in the world. LeBron had a way better time in Miami. Like, he's got his friends down there. It's going to be real. Like, bring LeBron back. We're not going to tax his money. You get it under the table.
If we're going to go into sports, this is a question I have, but I didn't see anybody asking. If LeBron won Miami this year, with one project,
we would win.
Would they take it to 7?
It'd be done in fucking 5. It would be no question done in 5. It's done in 5. It's done in 5. It's done in 5. LeBron scoring 40. LeBron score over 30 last year.
LeBron scored 40. Three games.
It's done in five against Steph Curry.
So three straight triple doubles from LeBron, and then you'll have two good games from Wade just taking over. And then if Goran gets you the other game, that's five. That's you're killing it.
It's over. It's over. It's five. It's five.
Are we talking about imaginary basketball?
Five.
Yeah.
We're talking about five.
Like, is this like theoretical basketball we're doing?
One, two, three, four.
I feel like it's the same thing.
I get it.
I always just like.
Dave Chappelle.
What if this happened?
I plead the fifth.
It's like if basketball was D&D. That's what you're doing. It's like if he was on this team with these people, this would have happened.
But it's more real than that, because this is what would happen,
no,
Brian.
I get it.
These are facts.
Sports facts.
Black kids aren't marketed to.
Gold State would not impale Chris Bosh. Like, yeah, who would they have had? Who did they have that
it's
would
not
have
about
them?
The talent, like, brother. You know what happens sometimes.
Out, like, my brother.
Guys get together and guys don't
role
get
playing
along.
Games. You always love role playing games.
No. In Miami, we got along. It was perfect.
But are you going to now? That's the question.
But Dwayne Wade,
we got new. If I was Dwayne Wade,
and I was disrespected with not the dollars, if I don't have that check with the most money.
There's not a lot of money to go around, man.
It's a bloviated contract for bad knees anyway. He can leave.
Oh, masterminds. We gon' get this forever. You know whenever we link up, my nigga, they think this shit come from outer space or something. Nigga, let's get this money, nigga. Woo! Woo! Masterminds. ROC, WMG. Jay, I got it. I got it. Four stacks for the heels on my bitch feet. Car seat still smelling like 10 keys. Tell a plug that I'm looking for an increase. Wingstop, fat boy, I need a 10 piece. Say a nigga name in the car star. Nigga switching lane to lane like Walmart. Sipping Bordeaux, out in Bordeaux. Has the lights flashing on the photo. Switch the Benzo for the Enzo. Back to the Benzo when the end's low. Switch your old bitch from a new bitch. Come a new bitch, something like a nympho. Fuck the game raw when I came in it. Getting money ever since I came in it. You couldn't stop me if you tried. Motherfucker, cause the devil is alive. Big guns, big whip. Rich nigga talking big shit. Double cup, gold wrist. Double up on the blow, bitch. 2 mil on that I-95. Bow your head cause it's time to pay tax. Opposition want me dead or alive. Motherfucker, but the devil is alive. The devil is alive. Bitch, I'm the truth. The devil is alive. Bitch, I'm the proof. The devil is alive. The devil is alive. Bitch, I'm alive. The devil is alive. Two kings on the big screen. Niggas seen a 36 at 16. 100K for the 16. Niggas stick dirty, but it's dick clean. My money going on the deep end. Dog, I have a milli for the weekend. Contract like a nigga play defense. Curry's in the Maybach, bitch, peeking. Now the bitches want a car hop. 6 cribs for the cars in the car lot. Dope boys on the gold, nigga. Win gold 6 times for a gold, nigga. Black bottle when the bad bitch. Club all money where the cash is. Dubai, I can do it like a sheep. Top flow, nigga, Burj Khalifa. Big guns, big whip. Rich nigga talking big shit. Double cup, gold wrist. Double up on the blow, bitch. 2 mil on that I-95. Bow your head cause it's time to pay tax. Opposition want me dead or alive. Motherfucker, but the devil is alive. The devil is alive. Bitch, I'm the truth. The devil is alive. Bitch, I'm the proof. The devil is alive.
I got a Ricky.
The devil is alive.
Yeah.
Bitch, I'm alive.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
The devil
yeah.
is alive.
It's a true false fiction. It's a true false fiction. It's over atheists. I never fuck with true religion. Am I down with the devil? Come on, root, come on, missing. It's that Lucifer juice and that 2 cup he's sipping. That you say, baby. Welcome to the dark side. Could have got blacklist for the crack shit. White Jesus in my crock pot. Mix the shit with some soda. Now I'm black Jesus, turn water to wine. And all I had to do was turn the stove up. East Coast, winning that life, nigga, cheat code. Hating is flaking, hit your free throws. The devil try to hit me with the Rico. Them black people. Devil want these niggas, hate their own kind. Gotta be the Illuminati if a nigga shine. Or it can't be a nigga if a nigga rich. Or it gotta be the devil, that's a nigga shit. Seen what I did to the stop and frisk.
Watch me.
Brooklyn on the Barney's like we on the bitch. Get the money to the hood, now we all win. Got that Barney's floor looking like a VIM. Black hoodie, black Scully. Bravado like Mavado, boy, I'm that gully. Getting white money, but I'm still black. All these niggas claiming king, but I'm still black. King Hover, Mansa, Musa. From a lot of devil was a lie, I'm the truth, yeah.
Big guns, big whips. Rich nigga talking big shit. Double cup, gold wrist. Double up on the blow, bitch. 2 mil on that I-95. Bow your head cause it's time to pay tax. Opposition want me dead or alive. Motherfucker, but the devil is alive. The devil is alive. Bitch, I'm the truth. The devil is alive. Bitch, I'm the proof. The devil is alive. The devil is alive. Bitch, I'm alive.
Church. Church.
story of the curious oysters. The sun was shining on the sea, shining with all its might. He did his very best to make the billows smooth and bright. And this was odd because it was the middle of the night. The walrus and the carpenter were walking close at hand. The beach was wide from side to side, but much too full of sand. Mr. Walrus, said the carpenter, my brain begins to perk. We'll sweep this clear in half a year, if you don't mind the work.
Work? The time has come, the walrus said, to talk of other things, of shoes and ships and sealing wax and cabbages and kings, and why the sea is boiling hot and whether pigs have wings. Calloo, callay, no work today. We're cabbages and kings.
Come and walk with us. The day is warm and bright. A pleasant walk, a pleasant talk would be a sheer delight.
Yes, and should we get hungry on the way, we'll stop and have a bite. But Mother Oyster winked her eye and shook her heavy head. She knew too well this was no time to leave her oyster bed.
The sea's nice. Take my advice and stay right here.
Mum said.
Yes, yes, of course, of course. But, the time has come, my little friends, to talk of other things. Of shoes and ships and sealing wax, cabbages and kings, and why the sea is boiling hot, and whether pigs have wings. Ha-ha! Calloo, callay, come run away. We're the cabbages and the kings. Let me see. A loaf of bread is what we chiefly need.
How about some pepper and salt and vinegar, eh?
Well, yes, a splendid idea. Very good indeed. Now, if you are ready, oysters, dear, we can begin the feed.
Feed?
Oh, yes. The time has come, my little friends, to talk of food and things.
Of peppercorns and mustard seed and other seasonings. We'll mix them all together in a sauce that's fit for kings. Calloo, callay, we'll eat today like cabbages and kings.
I weep for you. I deeply sympathize. For I've enjoyed your company, much more than you realize.
Little oysters, but answer there came none. And this was scarcely odd because
they'd been eaten.
Everyone.
I mean, he would fight back. Yes, you have to protect your flock. But, you know, I just don't feel like the level of the AME church, the mantra has always been to create a real solution. And they understand that it's through the real nonviolent solidarity. Nonviolence doesn't mean not fighting back when you're attacked. What it means is not being the offender, not being the oppressor, not being the one that's doing what this man did and going up and shooting up a church, you know?
He would never have reached nonviolence. It's
winning in the court, winning legally.
Yeah.
Legislation.
Because the AME Church is the first true black organization in America, even before the NAACP was formed, before any agency was formed, that truly took things to legislation and understood a political system that was beyond the grasp of the average black person in America, and it brought unity, education, and learning. That's why this is such a staple. And you know, I had to see on Facebook the terrible comment from the religion hater. You know, your average super atheist is just a dick.
Even give him power.
You know, with his nonsense about the Christians deserve this because of all the blah. You know, that's not how karma works.
No one deserves this.
Exactly.
I mean, here's the thing. We all deserve death. No one deserves to die at the hands of another man. Like, we all deserve to die when God calls us up to heaven at his particular time. No one deserves to die at the hand of another man because it is not our place as humans to take anyone else's life. I'm going to put that out there as a noise and so message. Like, if you are a person and you hear this message, if you were within the range of my voice, you are not allowed to kill anyone, period. Don't do that.
Don't do it.
There's always
another way. You went too far. You could do all kinds of stuff. You could punch a guy. I mean, that's not cool, but you can still do it.
You can disarm. You can get out of the situation.
You can't take a bullet back. That's my thing. You can't take a bullet. Once someone is dead, you cannot undead them.
What would have been his consequences for him just walking away? And he says, "You know, I'm not doing
this." Oh, just drawing the gun, and people holding him down, holding up
the joint, and then putting down the gun, giving it to them.
No, I think that they wouldn't have called the cops. They would have talked to him and eventually tried to figure out what's best for him, whether it be talking to his parents, getting him set up with a mental advisor, getting him put in psychotherapy for the night. There's not necessarily the legal charges that would have happened. And you know, this is, of course, a hypothetical scenario, and sadly, it's not what happened.
Sadly, hypothetical.
For both of y'all. Pertain to y'all too, I guess. So,
what would you say?
Like, if this is your family member, if this is your cousin?
This isn't me, and this isn't reflective of my views and my family, but I wish I could have helped him and been there for him.
I would say, you could do a lot of things better with your time. Than murdering people. I don't care who you're related to. I don't care if you're my brother or my cousin or my aunt or my uncle. I love you if my family, and I love you if you're not my family.
But if you kill somebody, that's not okay with me. Not cool.
No, that's what I'm saying. It's not reflective of me or the real.
If we can address those issues, that group, then we can stop that.
We can go off air now. This song is really good, so we're going to... Thanks for just tuning into the Noise Show.
We love
you,
people.
Do it again if you feel like it.
Peace, love, Charleston. And pray for Charleston, people. Come out to the poorhouse.
Yeah, pray for each other.